community.
Mm-hmm.
So we should always acknowledge this affinity in order to get rid of our doubts. Salah ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad. Allahumma salli
ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad.
Just a few words on the holy month that we've entered today, Rajab, before we go into the Q&A. Today is the first day of Rajab, which is very significant in our training to acknowledge this affinity. Every year, there's a boot camp. There's a spiritual, metaphysical boot camp in the heavens. Today it started. In the same way, when you go into the army, you're not expected to do 500 push-ups on the first day. You don't run a marathon on the first day. Likewise, we're going into something very special now, and Allah wants to train us in Rajab and Shaban before we enter Shahr Ramadan. That's why Shahr Ramadan, you notice the first 10 days are a bit busy. They didn't train for it from now. Now is the time to train for it. From Rajab. You see, Rajab is the month of Imam Ali alayhi salam. Sha'ban is the month of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Shahr Ramadan is the month of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we start from now. If you look at the narrations, there are so many. I'll leave that to you guys to look at. But just a few words on it would be good to remember. Rajab is known as the month of Takhalli, of emptying. Sha'ban is tahalli, of decorating. Shahr Ramadan is tajalli, of Allah manifests himself to you in Shahr Ramadan if you train correctly in these 2 months. In the month of tahalli, of emptying, what are you emptying? You're emptying the sins within you, the darknesses that you've taken with you throughout the whole year. So in the same way that the cup is dirty, and you put water into the cup, and it comes out with dirty water, you don't want to put water into it straight away, take it to Shahr Ramadan like that. You want to empty the cup first, a clean cup. So when it comes to Sha'ban, you decorate it with the adaya that we have, Ajal Sha'ban here, etc. And Shahr Ramadan, you're ready, that's it, you offer your heart to Allah. Empty, decorate it, and you offer it. All for one night, Laylatul Qadr. It's all for that one night. So that you finally understand, Inna anzalnahu, you know what that rule finally is. Because at 25 years, I don't know what it is. This is another chance for me to understand. Every year we have a chance. So we start the training from now. So, how do we start this training? In this month, istighfar is a main component. So always be istighfarullah, everywhere you are, the car, the train, the bus, coming here, before you sleep, when you wake up, istighfarullah. It's the month of tawbah. They used to say, Imam Zain al-Abidin alayhi salam, he used to, in Rajab, go next to the Kaaba, and he would do sujood. And no more, no less, would always say, Allah qad dhamma min abdik, fa yasma afu min abdik. No more, no less. He just keeps saying it again and again and again. It's the month of Tawbah. In this month, we get used to fasting. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi used to say that fast this month, if you fast all of it, then you will be forgiven all your sins. You're protected from future sins. And you will face no thirst on the day of judgment. Now an old man came to the Prophet and he said, I'm sick, I can't fast the whole month of Rajab. So he told him, it's okay, fast the first day, so today, fast the middle of the month, and fast the last day of the month. And it would be as if you fasted the entire month. So if you can't fast the whole month, fast 3 days. Get used to fasting from now. Train your body from now. Train your soul from now. True fasting, but not eating, fasting. On the Day of Judgment, a voice calls out, Aina Rajabi Yum? Where are the people of Rajab? There's a people who Rajab means a lot to them. Things change in Rajab. It's not the same worshipping program. You have to make a new program of worship in Rajab. So Aina Rajabi Yum? Where are they? And there are thousands of angels to the left and to the right and they enter paradise. And when they ask Imam Sadiq, who are these Rajabi Yum? What does one have to do to be of the people of Rajab? He told him, Rajab Yun are the ones who fasted at least one day in Rajab. That's it. That's it, yeah, I know it. Wow, yeah, that's it. And you understand more about this when you look at the du'as of Rajab and the generosity of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A man came to Imam Sadiq and he asked him, teach me a du'a in Rajab. This man Sadiq told him, okay, and this is such a beautiful du'a. And we are advised to recite it after every salat in Rajab. And as much as we can after the salat as well, not just after the prayers, all the time. Ya man arjuhu li kulli khayr. He who I beg of mercy for comfort, hope, رجائي يعني أرجوه لكل خير وآمن سخطه عند كل شر and safe in his wrath from all evil. So mercy, hope and safety. يا من أرجوه لكل خير وآمن سخطه عند كل شر. يا من يعطي الكثير بالقليل. Gives a lot in return for little. This woman understand that. Wow, 1 million plus one day. Yes. You have القليل كثير بالقليل. Because when we look at Allah's generosity, sometimes we look at it from our perspective. Maybe we don't give that much, but Allah Subhanahu wa Taala gives everything, all the time. He just wants us to accept it. يعطي الكثير بالقليل. يا من يعطي من سأل ومن لم يسأل تحمل منه ورحمة. He gives you often, and also who doesn't ask him and doesn't even know him. تحمل منه ورحمة. Out of mercy. So he's generous. Imam Sadiq talks about safety, hope, and then rahma, mercy. You know the difference between Rahim and Rahman? Rahman is when you're merciful to the mu'mineen. But Rahim is you're merciful to everyone. Man lam yas'aluhu, wa lam ya'ruf. He doesn't ask him, he doesn't know him either. He still gives him. أعطني مسألتي إياك. Give me. And now Imam Sadiq, after mentioning all these things, what's he going to tell us to ask for? جميع خير الدنيا وجميع خير الآخرة. واصرف عندي مسألتي إياك جميع شر الدنيا وجميع شر الآخرة. Give me all that's good, everything. Ask for everything. This dua asks for everything in this world and the next. After you bring up Allah's mercy, safety, generosity, and hope, you ask for everything. And to give away all bad things from you. لأنه غير منقص ما أعطيت. It's never going to decrease. It's always growing more and more. It's always increasing. وزدني من فضلك يا كريم. And here the dua finishes. But then Imam Sadiq alayhi salam goes into his own world. The dua is always talking about all the jamal of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But in our religion, there's a balance between hope and faith. So now he goes into the jalal aspect of it. And the narrator says that Imam Sadiq, he put his left hand to his beard. He moved his finger in fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يا ذا الجلال والإكرام يا ذا النعماء والجود يا ذا المن والطول حفر الشركة على النار. He talks to Allah's majesty and he asks him to please keep my grey hairs protected from the fire. So this is a dua that's easily easily attained online. I recommend you learn it, I recommend you read it as much as you can this month. There are a lot more adaya in Maftiha Jinnah, check them out as well. Fast as much as you can. Inshallah, we are on the Rajabiyun, but we are the ones, Allah.